We're going to look at a steam valve rebuild and why you would rebuild a steam valve. There's three reasons to rebuild a steam valve. One would be if water or steam is dripping from the tip of the steam wand. The second would be if water or steam was coming from around the ball here at the top of the steam wand retaining nut. And the third would be if water or steam was coming from behind the handle where the handle presses the stem into the valve. Working on a steam valve should only be done with the machine unplugged, the steam gauge with no pressure at zero, and the machine cooled off so that you don't get burnt while you're doing this procedure. The first thing that we need to do is remove the sheet metal, the top housing, the side panel, the front, and the drain tray. At Synesso, we use a steam valve isolation ball valve that's located right here. Turning that handle 90 degrees to the tube turns the steam off, and this would isolate anything past the valve. To do the rebuild of the steam valve, you need food grade lubricant, you need a steam valve rebuild kit 1.7320, you need a very small screwdriver, a pair of pliers, 5/8 wrench, and a slotted screwdriver. The parts in the steam valve rebuild kit are the O-rings and the small bits that go inside. If you need to install the gasket face that is the seal inside the steam valve, there's a little bit of a trick to it. Press it in with your fingers. It has air trapped behind it. So if you take a very small screwdriver and slide it in between the rubber and the valve body and press down, then you can get it in there nice and flat. With this ball valve turned 90 degrees to make sure the steam valve is isolated, the next step is to remove the steam wand. The steam wand removed, we'll remove the steam valve tube. And we'll only loosen the tube here. We don't need to take it all the way off, but just take it loose. The back of the steam valve then unscrews next. There's a spring inside. Stem pulls out this way with two O-rings on it. And internally, there's a seal. And this is our seal to be replaced by the new one. In the top is a spring. The spring provides the tension against the steam wand ball to keep the wand from moving freely. At this point, reach into the steam valve and feel the surface of the seal to make sure that there are no pits or gouges in the face of the seal. It should feel nice and smooth when you drag your fingernail around the end of that seal. There's nothing more to do on the steam valve itself other than inspect for any kind of grit or debris or anything like that that needs to be removed. This one is pretty clean. With the steam valve pusher, the O-rings will be removed. I often just break them to get them off. And then we put the new ones on. With the new O-rings on the steam valve pusher, the new seal placed into the steam valve seal. We need to remove the original gasket from the steam valve nut. This sometimes takes a little bit of force to get it to come apart. So the new gasket goes over the steam valve nut like this. The new seal back inside the spring, carefully located in the cup of the seal. There's a cup on this end, the spring goes in there. Spin the back of the valve back together. And we want to smash that gasket in there pretty flat. So that's in nice and tight. Steam valve tube goes back on. Hold the nut on the steam valve. Tighten the tube at the top. Hold the nut on the ball valve. Tighten the tube at the bottom. And your pusher stem is ready to go back in. With a small amount of food grade grease, lubricate the O-rings. And very gently reinstall this pusher, being careful not to chip up the O-rings, and then double check that it presses in and out nice and smooth. If it hangs up or if the spring is binding, you may have to take it back apart to get the spring in. It may not be in the cup of the seal correctly. It should be a nice, easy, smooth push. To put the steam wand back on, put the new gasket on. Again, there's a smooth side and a sharp side. Smooth side first makes this a much easier process. The spring goes back in the top. We're going to put a little bit of lubrication on the threads. There's some downward force required to get the threads to start. This gasket needs to be crushed similarly to the body gasket. When we put these on, we need to be sure to get them on really tight. Hang on to the valve, twist this in so that you're getting a good smash on the Teflon gasket. The ball should turn nice and easy in here and the wand should stay in position. For rebuilding the wand, go to the hyperlink associated to this page. When reinstalling the side panel, put a small amount of lubrication right on the end of the pusher. Put your side panel back on. Snug one nut. Make sure that this has just a little bit of play here, and that you can feel a nice smooth operation of your steam valve. The rest of the sheet metal goes back on in the order that it came off, and that's rebuilding your steam valve.